Good evening, brothers and sisters. Our opening hymn is number 303 in the music issues. Gather us in, number 303. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And with your Brothers and sisters, it is the seventh Sunday of Easter. In fact, there's only one Sunday left, the Sunday of Pentecost. And so we stand with the whole church at saying, Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful as we wait for that blessed day. And so let us now acknowledge our sins, and so prepare our hearts to receive him in these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest. Begotten Son, Lord God.
Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience, as he promised until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon him together. They threw him out of the city and began to stone him. The witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. The word of the Lord. A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice saying to me, "Behold, I am coming soon. I bring with me the recompense I will give to each according to his deeds. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are they who wash their robes so as to have the right to the tree of life and enter the city through its gates. I, Jesus, sent my angel to give you this testimony for the churches. I am the root and offspring of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. Let the hearer say, come. Let the one who thirsts come forward, and the one who wants it receive the gift of life-giving water. The one who gives this testimony says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, I pray not only for them, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. That they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me, and I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me, and that you loved them even as you loved me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known, that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord. In all three of our readings today, there is a lifting up of one's eyes to heaven. We have Stephen, who looks up and sees the Son of Man, Jesus, seated on his throne beside his heavenly Father in his kingdom, and is thus condemned to death for such a vision, and yet knows Jesus, knows the Father so much that he can pray the very same prayer Jesus said from the cross, Father, forgive them. They know not what they are doing. We have John, the beloved apostle, giving us the very last words of the scriptures today. Yes, I am coming soon, says Jesus. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus, responds the church. So John gets this image of this conversation, this relationship between Jesus, the bridegroom, and his church, the bride. And then Jesus himself in the gospel, lifting up his eyes to heaven, seeing the face of his Father, and making this high priestly prayer, it's called, that they may all be one. It's the prayer that the whole prayer of the church is centered around. Take so many little lines from this in the prayers of the Mass. In fact, the book of Revelation, the book of Acts of the Apostles, and the Gospel of John, so much of the Mass is found in these readings. And I think a word that links all of these events together is the word attunement. I think all of them follow that word, attunement. Usually attunement is used to describe what's going on in the very earliest stages of life. A baby learns to attune themselves, especially to the mother. And in fact, in those first years of life, the whole foundation of one's relationships, one's identity, one's mission is set out based on that attunement between the baby and the mother. I think of this also with us and Mother Church. There's this attunement that happens every time we come to Mass, which is very similar to that which happens between child and mother. And so I wanted to go through maybe four ways that attunement is happening, that we can see the face of the Father as Jesus lift up his eyes to heaven, Stephen and John as well. There's an attunement there. And we hunger for that. We hunger for the face of God as a baby hungers for the face of his mother. So also we hunger for that presence, that attunement. And so the first way that God is present here in this Mass is in the form of his body. The body of Christ is the church. So that's really the first encounter you have with God is with the people gathered. It's in the body. The attunement that the child has, for instance, still in the mother's womb. The child feels the heartbeat of the mother. And you can think maybe every instance that the child leans against the mother's breast can still hear that heartbeat as something very familiar. The body is something that we attune ourselves with, and we become in relationship to one another through the body. And so the body of Christ, also the same. We all stand together, we sit together, we respond together, as so often in the book of Revelation, the church with one voice cries out. We become maybe too used to that fact that we all know when to sit, when to stand, when to kneel. But as someone that does many weddings and funerals and people not in the church come in, it's kind of intimidating just how much we are attuned with one another as part of the body of Christ. And so it's an incredible thing to have a place to come and attune with so many people. That's part of the mission of the church, to be that place where relationships can grow, even in those little ways, just through the body itself. The second way of attunement comes through the face. And so we look for the face of Christ. Jesus is our second encounter with God in the Mass through the person of the priest who represents the head of the church, his body. And so sorry that this is the face you have to attune to, but today you'll be happy to know we added much better faces to our lineup of priests in the diocese. We ordained four new men, and they're good men. I went to seminary with some of them. It's just an amazing thing to go as a priest and see ordinations, to see God calling continually new persons to stand as the head. So if you get a chance to meet them, you know, Deacon Liam O'Shea Creel, now Father Liam O'Shea Creel, he was here last summer. He's now a priest. He's going back to my hometown. I'll be happy to see him. If you see any of the new priests, you know, be sure to ask for their first blessing. It's a very intimate thing to receive. And again, attuning to the face of Jesus through the priest. Because again, it's just like the child and the mother. They say the first distance the child's eyes can recognize, can focus on, is the distance between the mother's arms and her face. So that the child can already then begin to look on that face and to change. You know, our facial expressions get formed not so much just by genetics, but through looking at other people and imitating what they do. And so again, Stephen, John, Jesus lifting up his eyes to heaven, keep ourselves on the face of Christ, on the face of Jesus, and our own faces will become attuned. The third attunement in Mass comes through the word, the voice. You know, the mother's voice makes the baby calm, makes the baby, you know, soothed. And all of us other, especially males, we try to imitate the voice with our own, you know, high pitch, like, oh, isn't that cute? Like, we're trying to imitate the voice of the mother, but we do a terrible job. It just looks ridiculous, right? Because that voice of the mother is so powerful. And the voice of God as well holds so much power. And I think one line especially in the gospel today that's been so powerful to me is It's kind of that first prayer of Jesus, for those who will believe in me through their word. I don't think there's any other line in Scripture that quite leaps out through the 2,000 years. Jesus is thinking of us right here when he says this line, for those who will believe through the word of the apostles. He's thinking of us. I think that's something incredible to think about. Every single moment of Jesus' life, his passion, death, and resurrection, he was thinking of us. So we should be attuned to that. We should read that and be like, Jesus, you're thinking of me right now at the Last Supper. Every one of these words, I'm there. You're speaking it to me. There's this attunement that happens through the Word of God, listening to that voice as something all too familiar then. Just as the baby recognizes the voice of the mother because already has heard it so often in the womb, so also out there in the world, recognizes that something familiar, something close, something so necessary. And then finally, the last attunement that happens here at Mass is the attunement through the meal, through the Eucharist, the bread of life. Just like the mother provides of her own body for the child, so also we get provided for from the body of Christ. There's nothing quite like a meal that brings people together. There's nothing like it. To take part in the same food, that body becomes a part of each of our bodies. In a sense, we become one body. And that meal always reminds us of that reality, that we are one, that we share the same life, that the mother and the baby share the same life, share the same blood, the same nourishment. And so in all these ways, we see that Mother Church is nurturing us in the Mass, these four ways, through the body, through one another, through the face of Jesus in the priest, through the Word of God, and through that meal and that nourishment. We are being nourished in Mother Church. There's nothing quite like motherhood. Again, the first years of a baby's life are so foundational to who they become. Motherhood is so dignified. And in these days, when motherhood is often under attack and lessened, we need to proclaim the goodness of it. You know, especially with Roe versus Wade, perhaps, please God, coming to a crashing halt, we need to proclaim the truth of motherhood. And one of the ways the bishop has done that is through walking with moms in need. It's this new thing that's already been going on, in fact, but will be pushed even harder to reaching moms who, again, don't know the beauty of motherhood. And maybe we're tempted through all these other voices of the world to forego this great gift, but instead reaching out to them and offering them the resources they need to find. That it's not so much, you know, in what they do that makes them ready to be a mother. It's who they are. It's in who they are. And again, the church is not so much what the church does that makes her so dignified. It's in who she is as the chosen one of God and each and every one of you. Again, it's not so much what you do for others, but who you are as chosen in God as his beloved children. And so in the heart of the church, let us attune ourselves to the face of the Father so that we may all be one as he is one, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, God makes all things new. With confidence in the Father's saving power, we now pray.
For Christians everywhere, may they live out their baptismal promises with joyful humility. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil authorities, may they remember and provide for the needs of the neediest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who endure lives of daily loneliness and isolation, may they receive the Church's offering of welcome and inclusion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community, may they embrace the gospel with heart and soul. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of Spencer and Michelle Kostinski, for whom this Mass is offered, and for the needs of all here present, for which we now pause to pray. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we have come to know and to believe in the love you have for us. Keep us faithful, fervent, and active in that love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Our offertory hymn is number 536, located in the songbook. Peace is flowing like a river. Number 536.
River flow.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples, and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his one divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
thy death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with the North American martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
See on us, love.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 330, located in the songbook, Seed, Scattered, and Sown, number 330.
Scattered and sown, we
Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Our closing hymn is number 601, located in the songbook, We Are the Light of the World, number 601.
Blessed.